So there's one type of immune therapy we haven't talked about, which we get questions on all the time at this conference, and that's what's going on potentially right now in several places, including City of Hope, and that's CAR T cell therapy. So if you're in the world of leukemia and lymphoma, a couple different types, it's changed the nature of that disease. It's a very, arguably, I don't know how you put it, it's a more specific type of immune therapy that's had dramatic results in types of leukemia and lymphoma. But now they've just started the trials in prostate. Can you give us some background there and tell us what's going on?
Sure. Actually, I don't have a lot of inside knowledge on that, but I did have one patient who, Tanya Dorf at the City of Hope has been treating with that particular therapy. It's a pretty kick-ass treatment. I mean, you have to be in the hospital for a couple of weeks because the immune system is so intensely activated that the treatment can make people quite ill. But this particular individual that is being monitored, followed also by my partner, Dr. Turner, had a very sharp decline in PSA after this treatment. And this individual did have advanced prostate cancer, had had a lot of previous treatments. So my own inside exposure to it is that not only on paper does it look hopeful, but we've actually seen one of our patients that seems to be getting a nice response to it.
That is really interesting. I didn't know that because that's a phase one. And so
Yeah.
if they're experiencing anything in a phase one, that's got to be interesting.
Yeah. Oh, I think so. Well, the design of this whole thing makes a whole lot of sense. So the reason it's a very expensive treatment, but the reason people are willing to spend the money is because of, as you've pointed out, in other disease types, it has been quite successful, and there's good reason to believe that it will be successful in prostate cancer.
Wow, that's exciting. So I remember for the audience, it's called CAR, CAR-T, CAR T. It's, I don't know. I mean, if I have to give a quick summary of it, it's highly, highly specific immune therapy, but it's just starting in clinical trial right down the street. And I looked up on the government website, and there's not many of these. I mean, Tanya Dorf, Dr. Dorf has got one of the first and only going on globally.
Yeah, it's like all it's a high risk, high reward proposition, but the design makes sense, and hopefully it'll prove to be effective in a high percentage of people that take it. If only 5 or 10% of the people respond, it may not be worth it because it's such a gigantically expensive and potentially toxic treatment. But of course, if we're able to really turn people around who are otherwise running out of options, that would be spectacular.
But we can't say necessarily right now if it's, I mean, did you see any response? You saw responses with Keytruda, so maybe these other types of immune therapies will be as good. We don't know, but did you saw anything that got you a couple patients here and there that got you very excited about the immune therapies that you were giving and other people are giving in offices?
Yeah, I mean, we published our results in Keytruda, and we showed in the patients we selected, which were men that had hormone-resistant disease, but their PSAs weren't very high, and generally speaking, they did not have extensive metastasis, maybe a few metastases. Over half of the patients with Keytruda had either stabilization of their rising PSA or regression of their PSA. So it was not an inconsequential impact. We published that in the Clinical Genitourinary Cancer about 2 months ago. So it's here to stay. I think that it's going to be a part of the treatment armamentarium going forward.